Welcome to all. Now we are going to solve a problem from knuckle joint. Design a knuckle joint to transmit 150 kN. The design stresses may be taken as 75 MPa in tension, 60 MPa in shear, and 150 MPa in compression. Right? Given data. P equal to 150 kN. That means 150 into 10 to the power 3 Newton per millimeter square. Sigma T equal to 75 MPa. That means 75 Newton per millimeter square. Tau equal to 60 MPa. That means 16 Newton per millimeter square. Sigma C equal to 150 MPa. That means 150 Newton per millimeter square. Failure of the solid rod in tension, right? At first, we can assume small d equal to diameter of the rod. We know that the load transmitted P equal to pi by 4 d square into sigma t, right? So, P value we know given in our problem 150 into 10 to the power 3, okay, and sigma t also given in our problem 75, right? If we substituting all values in this equation, means we can get d equal to 50.4, right? So we can say 52 millimeter. Now the various dimensions are featured as follows. Okay, the diameter of knuckle pin d1 equal to, we know d, right? So d1 equal to 52 millimeter. Outer diameter of eye D2 equal to 2D. So we can find D2 equal to 2 into 52. That means 104 millimeter. Then diameter of knuckle pin head and collar. D3 equal to 1.5D. Right? Here D value we know 52. Right? After substituting this value, we can find D3 equal to 78 millimeter. Then we are going to find thickness of a single eye or rod end, right? Small d equal to 1.25d, okay? So d value 52, right? So 1.25 into 52 means 65 millimeter. So t equal to 65 millimeter. Thickness of fork, small t1 equal to 0.75d, right? If we substitute in this d value, means we can get 39. Okay, say 40 millimeter. T1 equal to 40 millimeter. Then we are going to find thickness of pin head. T2 equal to 0.5D. That means 0.5 into 52 equal to 26 millimeter. Okay, next we are going to find the failure of the knuckle pin in shear. Right, since the knuckle pin is in double shear, therefore the load P equal to 2 into pi by 4 d1 square into tau, right? P equal to 150 into 10 to the power 3, okay? D1 52, already we have been found, okay? From this formula we can find tau, right? So we can get 4248 tau. So tau equal to 150 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 4248. Okay, so finally we can find tau equal to 35.3 Newton per millimeter square. That means 35.3 MPa. Okay, next we are going to find the failure of the single eye or rod end in tension. Okay, the single eye or rod end may be fail in tension due to the load. So we know that the suitable formula P equal to D2 minus D1 into T into sigma T, right? So you can substitute P value 150 into 10 to the power 3, okay? And D2 equal to 104, D1 equal to 52, right? Small t we know 65, right? After substituting all values in this formula, means we can find sigma t equal to 44.4 Newton per millimeter square. That means 44.4 MPa, right? Then we are going to find failure of the single eye or rod end in shearing. Okay, the single eye or rod end may be fail in shearing due to the load. So we know that P equal to D2 minus D1 into T into tau, right? P we know load 150 into 10 to the power 3, right? D2 104, D1 52, T equal to 65. After substituting all values, right, we can get tau equal to 44.4 Newton per meter millimeter square. That means 44.4 megapascal. Then we are going to failure of the single eye or rod end in crushing. The single eye or rod end may fail in crushing due to the load. So we know that P equal to 150 into 10 to the power 3 equal P equal to D1 into T into sigma C, right? P we know 150 into 10 to the power 3, right? And T equal to 65, D1 equal to 52, okay? Finally, we can get sigma C equal to 44.4 Newton per millimeter square. That means 44.4 megapascal, right? Next, we are going to find the failure of the fourth end in tension. Right, the fourth end may be fail in tension due to the load. P equal to D2 minus D1 into 2T1 into sigma T. Right, P equal to 150 into 10 to the power 3, D1 equal to 52, D2 equal to 104, right, T1 equal to 40. Okay, after substituting all values, we can get sigma T equal to 36 Newton per millimeter square. That means 36 megapascal, right? Then we are going to find failure of the fourth end in shear, right? The fourth end may be fail in shear due to the load. So that is suitable formula P equal to D2 minus D1 into 2T1 into tau, right? So P equal to 150 into 10 to the power 3, D2 equal to 104, D1 equal to 52, T1 equal to 40. Already we have been find this value, right? After substituting all values in this formula means we can get tau equal to 36 Newton per millimeter square. That means 36 megapascal. Okay. Finally, we are going to find the failure of the fourth end in crushing. Right, the fourth end may be fail in crushing due to the load. P equal to D1 into 2T1 into sigma C. Okay, P equal to 150 Newton per 150 into 10 to the power 3. Right, D1 equal to 52 and T1 equal to 40. Right, so finally we can get sigma C equal to 150 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 4000. 180 equal to 36 Newton per millimeter square. That means 36 megapascal. Okay. So we can see that the induced stresses are less than the given design stresses. So therefore this design is safe. Right. We can refer the design for design of machine elements VB Bhandari and RS Guru. Thank you.